It's springtime, it's aphid season. I'm gonna show you how to scout for aphids, be prepared for them, and things that you can do in the garden to help suppress the aphids this year. I'm David Spencer, welcome to Gardening with Bugs. It's been an unseasonably cool spring here at Full Circle Farm, so everything's a bit behind. Even my gardens are looking like it's early April, really. But aphid pressure isn't on my plants like they would be, and maybe that's due to temperature. So I'm sort of awaiting, especially the weather turning this week, actually, finally, I'm expecting aphid explosions to just explode like they tend to do. Now, that's not necessarily a guarantee because sometimes the predators have had a chance to catch up. So when we're looking for aphids in the yard, we also want to make sure that there's predators there. So what I'm gonna do today is walk you through some of the spots where I know aphids are gonna show up early, and I'm gonna look for signs of predation. Now, the most important thing you need to know right off the bat about aphids is that there are hundreds of species. There's more than hundreds, but there's hundreds that I'm dealing with here in the yard at any given time. And most aphid species are specific to a group of plants. So the ones that are infecting your roses are not necessarily the same ones that are affecting your cabbages. And you've probably noticed that they're different colors. And to complicate things, some species can have different colors, but let's just generalize and say like the black aphid is different than the teal colored aphid, which is different than the green aphids. Now, predators, however, are usually much more general. So a predator that eats the black aphid may also eat the red aphid and the green aphid and the teal aphid. So when we're looking for a predator of aphids on a specific plant, we know that that predator will finish eating those aphids and then move over to another colony of aphids. So the predators are the most important thing to find in your yard. There's some exceptions. So an aphidious wasp is a tiny, like almost microscopic wasp that parasitizes aphids. Now, sometimes some species of aphidius or other parasitoids like that are host specific, so they'll only be able to parasitize one type of aphid. But generally speaking, and even amongst the parasitoids, they usually have a general host range. So again, if you see signs of predation, your aphid population will decrease. Home growers in particular there's usually two extremes. You usually just couldn't care less about the yard, whatever happens, happens, and then suddenly you have a problem to deal with. Or you're super keen, and the second you see a bug on your plant, you're keen to whip out the old home concoction pesticide that some internet person told you to use. Now, both of those I don't advise. There's somewhere in the happy middle that you need to find in order for you to be more relaxed in the garden and just kind of enjoy nature taking its course. So when you're looking for aphids, you have to right away understand that they need to be here. They have to explode in the spring along with rapid plant growth so that their numbers get high enough to sustain the population of all the predators that eat aphids, which is pretty much all of them. So one of the first signs looking for aphids is the signs of ants. Now, there's a couple situations where you're going to see ants in the garden, and one of them, it has nothing to do with aphids, and that is where there are extra floral nectary. So some plants produce almost like a nectar, a sugary water, which attracts pollinators. That's just sort of how they've evolved. So sometimes ants, like particularly on beans, or sometimes on specific fruit trees, are going after these extra floral nectaries. The other time you're gonna see ants is because they're farming the aphids. And I know most people are familiar with this concept now. Most species of ants will be attracted to sugary substances, and aphids produce honeydew, and that attracts these ants. Now, ants are related to wasps and bees. They're some of the smarter, more agile, if you can think of it that way, insects out in the garden. So they can recognize predators and remove them. They can also recognize fresh growth and grab aphids and move them as well. So typically with aphid control, we want to control the aphids, but when we're scouting, looking for ants is a good clue.
Where's the ant?
What did you find?
I don't know, but I can't. Oh, the ant! It's right there.
What's the ant eating?
See that shiny stuff? It's aphid poo.
The shiny stuff is aphid poo, that's right. So there's honeydew. Mm-hmm. And then above it is...
Poo's aphids.
God, yeah, some weird species of aphid on maples.
They're white.
What color are their eyes?
Red.
Good job. The other obvious place to look for aphids is in fresh growth on plants that you suspect will have aphids. So I know that I grow hops, so I have the hop aphid show up, and I know that the hop aphid will also infect stinging nettle. So here I'm checking my stinging nettle, and lo and behold, I've got aphids here. There are no aphids on the hop yet. So this is the plant that they've established on, probably because the growth has attracted them in some way. Another usual suspect is, of course, the cherry tree, and here I do not have that black aphid established yet, so things are looking relatively smooth there. I am finding caterpillars in here, however, and that has been a bad year for caterpillars. This was a surprising one. This is on snowberry. So I found a red aphid on the snowberry, but look at this. What's on the tip of the leaf is an egg, and this egg is a syrphid fly egg. So the syrphid fly larva is a predator of aphids. It emerges as an adult eventually, which is just a pollinator. Some of them are migratory, but regardless, they're one of the more important insects in the garden. So this particular aphid species, syrphid species, I don't know what it is, but most of them will eat between 100 and several thousand aphids. So I'm not too concerned about this aphid colony here with the egg laid next to it. One of the other things I tell home growers about aphids is when you find the aphids, if there's anything other than aphids there, it is almost always a predator. So when you see like a growing tip of a rose covered in green peach aphid, if you don't see anything else, then it's safe to say that's a new aphid colony. But as soon as you see one that's parasitized, so it's swollen and bronze looking, or you find one that has been parasitized, you see a little exit hole in it, or if you're really keen-eyed, you can find the little parasitoids there, or any weird looking larva, egg, it is probably a predator, and you probably don't have to do anything for that aphid colony. Now, while I always tell people just to relax about aphids, of course, it's important to recognize that they spread disease, they can ruin growing tips, and they can distort the plants. So economically, it's still important in your yard because they can kill young plants. They will almost never kill an established plant. So in those cases, you can probably just leave them. But something like peppers, if they get aphids early, you're gonna lose that growing tip. Sometimes that can be enough to distort the plant for the rest of its growing season. So it is always important to not just be totally carefree about aphids. You do want to establish for yourself a threshold where eventually you're going to have to act. A little bit's okay, but at some point you're gonna need to act. Now, if you ever do have to make some sort of intervention besides the release of beneficial insects, which in some cases is applicable, then the best thing you can do is just plain water spray them off. The reason why plain water is so important is because, first of all, it's the action of the water knocking them off that in some cases breaks off their piercing mouthpiece. So they survive, they crawl down, their instincts to go right back up to the plant. They can't hurt the plant any further, and it allows the predators to kind of find them and remain there as well. Plus, without having any sort of chemical soap or smell there, the predators will be able to smell the aphids and the honeydew and be able to hone in on that particular aphid colony and reduce it further. So it's your best course of action is always just a strong blast of water, not enough to damage the plant, but just enough to knock them off. You could, of course, just flick the leaves. A lot of them fall off that way, and it's usually the bigger pregnant ones anyways, the ones that are about to give birth. Those are sort of the only things you want to do. Don't look up on the internet some household remedy and start mixing all these things from under your sink. That's a harsh chemical. It damages your plants. It prevents predators from wanting to go anywhere near it. And that is usually the cause of bad aphid infestations, is because somebody has applied some sort of inhibiting chemical in the yard, and that's allowed the aphids to get out of control. Trust me, if there was a chemical that killed aphids and nothing else, there wouldn't be a whole lot of aphid problems. Okay, here's a rose bush that we actually inoculated with aphids earlier in the year. To see if we can attract some early season predators. And they did get the inoculation aphid. Then it went away. Then we did end up with a few more aphids. Predators have come back. It's been relatively clean, but as I look now, you can see aphids right here. Really hard to see. They're essentially the same color, but I'm trying to get some light in there. So let's take a look for some predators. Which these guys are under control. As a rule of thumb, if you see an aphid, look for anything else in the vicinity. That's probably a predator. We might have one right there. See that little guy crawling around? Super small, really long antennas, which usually means it's a wasp. Can't tell exactly, but my guess would be that would be an aphidious aphid parasitoid. So I'm not sure if he's sniffing out maybe whatever's emerging from the leaf there, maybe a thrips pupa or something. It's not always the case that they're going to be predators. There's some spit. And we've got the odd leaf hopper kicking around by the looks of it as well. Other than the wasp, there's a great number of predators kicking around here, either. They must be elsewhere.
Did I let him go? Oh no, he's right on the camera.
Oh, but is he inside? Did he fly away?
Yeah, he was right in the camera.
What else did you find? Should we find something else? Take a look, make sure you get it centered. What do you think it is? Let's take a look.